Are you trying to add some external users to your Testflight app? In this video, we are going to tackle just that. Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video, I am going to move forward from testing with internal testers inside Testflight. We are going to tackle external testers. We are going to talk about the public link and how you can share that inside the Testflight app. So I want you to hit that subscribe button and let's dive in. So let's get started adding some external users. In the previous video, I have added some internal users, and that is pretty quick to do so. But today we are going to tackle external users, those that you don't have emails on your iTunes App Store account. So what you have to do is go to Testflight. Of course, you have to have a valid build available. Go ahead and take a look at the whole playlist if you are new to this video. So click on Testflight here. And as you can see here, we have a button, add external testers. So first we need to create a group, and I usually call these externals. And let's click on create there. And there you go. As you can see, we have some testers, but we will ask for testers to join by a link, and we will do that in just a moment. Otherwise, you can just simply click on this plus button and add a new tester. So what we have to do first before we add some testers to add a build, and let's just add this build. Let's just select, click on next here, and we don't have to have a sign in our app, so we are not just going to select sign-in required, but we are going to select automatically notify testers. Let's submit for review, because we have to submit for review. These are external testers and not internal, so Apple needs to review your app. Now, this usually takes around a day or two, but once you do have that, we are going to come back here to testers and we are going to select our build. But for now, let's just wait for that one day. So after waiting a few days, we still haven't received some feedback from Apple, and that is kind of the case. They really take their time, so make sure that you submit your first build to the test flight as soon as possible. We have waited, I believe, 4 or 5 days, but I will need to move forward with this tutorial. So I have opened up one of my client's app. I have blurred everything out. Of course, that is private. And I will move on with the tutorial. So we want to create testers, like external testers. And I will talk a little bit about this public link that we have here. First of all, make sure that you have a valid build here. And it needs to be available for testing. That's what we waited for the test app that I have created in the previous episodes. By the way, if you are new here, go ahead and take a look at the whole playlist, link in the description, so you can understand what we are doing here. So let's go back here to testers, and you will see these external test groups. And what you can do is just create a brand new group, which you already did, and add testers manually. Like, click on here, select add new testers, and enter their email, first name, last name, and you could email them so they can open up this build on the Testflight app. Otherwise, which is let me just show you how many there's a limit for this. I believe it's 10,000 available slots here, so a lot. Now, if you don't want to bother them with their email, or they don't want to give you their email, you could send them a public link. Now, you can create one here or disable one. You could just copy the link and send it over. And of course, you can set a limit. As you can see, it's 11 here. Now, that is basically it. That's how easy it is to create external users. And of course, if you don't have emails for your testers, then you could just simply send out a public link. So now you know how you can send out your Testflight app to external testers via email or with that public link. How awesome is that? Now, I want you to hit that notification bell, because in my next video, we are going to talk about crashes in Testflight. That's right, we are going to tackle that crash that we have added into our app. In the meantime, make sure to check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about Swift UI in general, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.